If you have ever cooked a recipe from an Australian Women's Weekly cookbook, chances are that it's been tested by our next guest. Here to share her kitchen secrets is Pamela Clark from the Australian Women's Weekly. Welcome to the show.
Thank you, Sarah.
What are we making today?
We're making a raw strawberry cream cheesecake.
Ooh.
Totally vegan.
Totally. What does that
totally
mean
vegan.
Exactly?
No animal products at all.
Okay.
No gelatin, no eggs, dairy.
I've never met a vegan.
I bet you there's someone in the audience. There you go.
Any vegans?
There you are.
Well, let's get
you
started.
Can eat it.
And let's get started on making it. What's first?
In here we've got macadamia nuts, almond meal, dates, coconut, mm-hmm. and this becomes the base of the cheesecake. Mm-hmm. And we've got to add some coconut oil, mm-hmm. just a tablespoon, like that. Then we're going to whiz that around.
Okay.
Very quickly.
What's the coconut oil do? Gives it lubrication.
Just holds it together. Yeah. And then we're going to put it into this 23-centimetre springform pan, mm-hmm. and press that in.
Okay, I can do that. Okay. Steve is very handy in the kitchen.
Yeah, what do I need to do? I won Celebrity Come Dine With Me. Did you know that?
Did you just?
I'm not joking, I did.
Was that the one with... Were you on the same one as Carlotta? Huh.
No, I was against Shane Warne's wife.
There it is.
At the time, I don't know who the other people were. They couldn't cook, that's why I won.
Oh.
What can I do?
Well, I can press this in if you like.
Press that in.
Yep.
Now, here's a little trick from Sophia.
Yes.
In the recipe, it says
we love this.
To use the spoon,
yep.
but if you use the lid of the spray oil pan, it does wonders.
There you go.
So fantastic. Just press that in
press
nice
that down
and
nice
firmly.
And tight. Yep. And you've been at the Women's Weekly for a very long time. You were there during ITA's days as well.
Even pre-ITA.
Wow.
Why are the cashews wet?
Because they've been soaked overnight.
In what?
You'd be wet if you'd been soaked
yeah,
overnight.
I know.
It's just to soften them and make them nice and creamy when they're whipped together. And this is the filling part. So
what's in there?
There's cashews, mm-hmm. lemon rind, lemon juice, coconut oil, cocoa butter, which is probably the only thing you can't get from the supermarket. The rest you can get these days from the supermarket, and the agave syrup.
So are we attempting to make a healthy cheesecake here? Is that the plan?
Very, very healthy, Steve.
So that won't put any weight back on that I've lost, all the weight I've lost? No?
I wouldn't say that.
But it looks pretty healthy.
But it is healthy.
All right,
it is
so
healthy.
This base is done. Well, this is much nicer than a biscuit base, right?
Okay, how about we give Steve the strawberries to do?
Okay.
Seriously? Where do you
now
want me to put them?
Now, these are done. I'll show you. Nice and neatly.
I don't want any laughing over there. I know what I'm doing here. Round the edge.
Round the edge. Like little soldiers.
That's a little difficult.
All the way. No, other way up. Other way up.
Well, does it really matter?
Yes,
it's got to be neat, Steve.
Seriously. Okay, I'm doing it. Just relax, everybody. That'll take a while, though.
If you put it down, you can do two hands.
No, I can't. I'm not ambidextrous.
While Steve gets the strawberries ready, should we make the filling?
Okay, so this is this consists of your soaked cashew nuts.
Yes.
Raw cashews. Mm-hmm. The only reason, as Steve pointed out, is to make them nice and soft and creamy.
Yes.
Lemon rind or zest, whatever you want to call it, mm-hmm. agave syrup, a coconut oil, coconut yogurt.
Ooh.
Now, all we've got to do, this has been done because this is a wonderful machine,
yes.
but it's a noisy
beast. Very noisy.
A noisy
yes,
beast.
It's not good for TV.
So, no. So, what we've done, we're just going to pour this.
I've got the worst job. This
come
is
on,
awful.
Hurry up.
How come you just get to pound around with a few nuts? I've got to stick strawberries all over this thing.
Well, do you want a hand?
No, I'm getting there.
Can you reach the bowl?
Yes.
Coleman.
Give him a ladder.
We're making a healthy
faster.
Cheesecake, Jono, so you don't get fatter.
Now, I love your Women's Weekly Children's Birthday
Who
cookbook.
Doesn't?
I love that
you
book.
You know, that came out in 1980.
Wow!
Yes,
wow.
And we now keep it in print because people like you want it for the next generation.
Well,
you know?
I remember being a little girl and flicking through and picking out the cakes that I wanted, and I made Paul the number one cake for his first birthday. And Aisha was saying that back in the day, she'd have
sisters
like you, Pamela, in the kitchen whipping up
trains
and all those other cakes.
We made many a cake for Kath and Ben. Many.
Oh,
Kate
fantastic.
And Ben, yes.
Hang
Come on.
On,
are you done?
Hang on.
It's like
one
watching paint dry. Right.
There we go.
Well done. So, I'm not doing much, am I?
Giving orders, you're good at that.
I'm a bit of a bossy boots, I have to say. Never mind. So that's about two-thirds of that goes in there.
Okay.
Okay.
So this is going to be layered a little
spatula. I'll just test that.
There we go. This one?
Thank you. This is good. I like having all these assistants. Push that around there. You can do that.
And when you're testing...
No, I've done enough. You keep going.
When you're testing
things... Do you want
things...
to put the strawberry puree into there?
I had enough mess on my hands. You do it.
Such a complainer. When you are testing recipes in the Women's Weekly Kitchen, how many goes do you have at each recipe? Do you completely stuff them up a couple of times so
depends,
we don't have to?
Depends.
Okay.
Baking recipes, we often stuff up.
Yeah.
Because, you know, it's tricky. It's really chemistry and it's a science and all the rest of it.
Yep.
So, yes, we do.
What's next?
Wait. Have you not heard of patience being a virtue?
Yes.
Okay, sorry.
All right, so we're mixing in the puree
with
the leftover.
We're mixing in there. It's going to be a little bit marbled, I think, but not to worry.
That's okay.
Now, because perfect world, you'd put that in the fridge, okay?
Yep.
So settle it down a bit and let it firm. But we don't have that kind of time.
No.
So we've got a regular spoon over there, like a dessert
like
spoon
that.
Or something.
Yep.
So we're going to tip this over the top. But just to sort of spread it out a little bit, you just do it over the back of a spoon. Otherwise, it'll sort of drill down into the mixture and make a bit of a mess.
And these are the great tips because usually with cookbooks, they want you to buy all these fancy utensils and cooking, utensils and things like that. But if you can just use bits and pieces around
well,
your kitchen,
exactly.
It's
and the top of a oil spray oil can to.
So this is to get a layer.
A layered look is always good, Steve.
And look at this finished product.
So you get the idea.
On the end, this looks amazing, Pamela. Who would like to taste? Jessica is our official sweet taster.
Because I accosted this amazing woman in the hallway.
Yes, she did.
Oh, all these cakes and things that you do.
Well, while you trial this.
Shall I cut?
Yeah, you cut, Steve. There are more kitchen secrets on offer
the
with the Australian Women's Weekly Vegan Kitchen Cookbook, which is out now. How is it?
Isn't it gorgeous? Oh. Now, you're going to do this properly?
Well, I don't know. This is going to be a...
What does that mean? You get a knife and you stick it in the middle.
Well, we've had Pamela Clark showing us how to make this gorgeous vegan cheesecake.
Yep. Wow.
Verdict, guys?
Yum.
Amazing.
The best.
So good. So
you are
good.
So clever. Can Jeez. I take you home?
No.
Oh. You can read all about this recipe in the brand new Women's Weekly Vegan Kitchen. Oh, you're freaking me out, don't you?
Yeah, this reminds me of an episode of Jerry Springer.
Yeah. How good does this look?
Yeah, it reminds me of our favourite David Bowie song, Vegan Be Heroes.
Yeah.
Really bad.
Steve Price.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for being with us.
Thank you.
It's pricey. Pricey.
Thank you, Jono.
Get back to the radio station.
You will next week.
See you soon. Bye, guys. Thanks for being with us.